Imagine this. You are a senior executive in a large energy company, and you've been tasked your organization to take to net zero by 2050. Currently, your company emits 50 million tons of emissions every year, and you generate $100 billion in annual revenues. The stakes are high, and the task before you feels impossible. Hopefully, it is not impossible. Faced with thousands of potential options, where do you even start? What's the first step in the puzzle? You know your company inside and out. You understand every process, every pipeline, every plant site. But now you are faced with evaluating thousands of different options. Which technology should you explore? Should you retrofit your assets with carbon capture technologies? Should you invest in green hydrogen production? How are you tackling the supply of new materials? What if a groundbreaking technology occurs and it cuts the decarbonization cost by half? How do you account for unique opportunities that exist from resources like renewable energies? Traditional approaches to decarbonization analysis are slow, often taking months to run analysis just for a few representative cases. To make better decisions and avoid costly mistakes, you need to perform analysis over and over again, hundreds of scenarios, if not thousands of scenarios. This requires a groundbreaking platform that can rapidly screen options, assess feasibility, and identify the most cost-optimal decarbonization options. Such a platform must integrate real-world data, account for regional renewable resources, and integrate understanding of emerging technologies. On top of that, you need to perform different types of analysis: cost analysis, emissions analysis, optimization. For the past decade, I've been driven by one question: how can we transform this challenge into an opportunity? And this journey started at MIT, at MIT Energy Initiative, as a research project. And the initial scope of the project was evaluating all the potential decarbonization technologies and pick the most viable ones. And I envisioned that we need to create a software. And this software can streamline how we are doing this sort of analysis. And more importantly, we can keep the results up to date. And today, it has evolved into a mission. A mission to empower companies and all the users around the world to tackle this challenge test with clarity, confidence, and action. So what's the solution? It lies in a new integrated modeling approach, a way to bring all the critical components together into a single system. The platform integrates plant-level data with curated databases and customizable first principle models. This powerful combination enables you to effectively understand technical, economic, and environmental impact of your choices, ensuring informed decision making. Take a moment to consider this. Without the power of integrated approach, you need to rely on fragmented analysis, and now you can use, your team can use, a platform that can visualize the entire journey to net zero with confidence. You can identify the most economical pathways, adapt to new technologies, and make data-driven decisions that align with your company's goals as well as environmental commitments. Now let's focus on a real-world example. So let's pick a sector. I didn't pick the AI. But I picked a sector from today's challenges: long-haul trucking. Long-haul trucks accounts for a significant portion of the current emission intensity of today's global greenhouse gas emissions. And it makes a very high-impact sector to decarbonize. Imagine trying to decarbonize a fleet of long-haul trucks. You have many options. You can electrify the trucks with better electric trucks. You can use hydrogen with hydrogen fuel cell electric trucks, or you can use alternative fuels like biofuels or synthetic fuels. How about the infrastructure requirement? Do you have the charging stations? Do you have the fueling stations? Do you have the entire supply chain figured out for the alternative fuels? And you can easily see, for just a simple example, the amount of analysis you need to run grows exponentially. Now let's take a deeper dive. Green hydrogen. So we can use green hydrogen to power our long-haul trucks. Green hydrogen holds an incredible promise, but its viability hinges on location, technology, and resources. For demonstration purposes, I just pick a location in the Gulf Coast. And once I pick this location, we need to also identify the set of technologies we can use. And for this particular case, I am choosing solar PVs, wind turbines, and proton exchange membrane electrolyzers. And once we have the location, we also need to gather weather data at high temporal resolution to understand the impact of variabilities in these renewable resources. And here, in this case, I picked an example for an hourly resolution data for a full for an entire year. And once you have that data, now you can design your system. The system needs to operate continuously to be able to meet your hydrogen demand. And once we optimize everything, now we have an optimized operation, optimized system design, and a cost and emission associated with all this system configuration. Now that we understand the green hydrogen piece of the puzzle, let's get back to our story. So we were talking about decarbonizing long-haul trucking. So actually, our aim is not to produce green hydrogen, but to use that green hydrogen to power a truck. So green hydrogen production was only the first step in this entire supply chain. Now we need to take into account transportation of hydrogen, pipelines, storing hydrogen, fueling stations, fueling trucks, so on and so forth. You see the complexity. So to be able to do a holistic analysis, you need to include all of these and represent the supply chain. In just minutes, with our current platform, we can map out the entire supply chain from green hydrogen production all the way to powering fuel cell trucks. What once took months of analysis now happens in moments. And this isn't just a time saver. It's a transformation in how decisions are made for energy transition. And green hydrogen produced in one specific location was just one scenario. How does this solution compare to other hydrogen production options? How about if we produce green hydrogen in another location? If we use other powertrain options? There are numerous scenarios we can think of, and you need to explore all these scenarios before making informed decisions for your particular application. To navigate this complexity, we need tools that deliver depth to uncover insights through comprehensive analysis. Speed, delivering results rapidly, empowering timely decisions. And precision, ensuring every analysis is accurate and actionable. The need for advanced integrated analysis has never been greater. It's what will enable us to navigate complexity, embrace innovation, and create a world that thrives sustainably. We have existing sustainability challenges and also growing challenges with new needs for data centers, revolution in AI. The energy requirement is increasing. We have new technologies both on the demand side and production side. And we need to tackle all of these together. Building a sustainable future is not without its challenges, but it is within our reach. With the right tools, we can transform this transition into a seamless reality. Together, we can redefine what's possible and lay the foundation for a thriving net zero world. The journey to a sustainable future starts now. Thank you.